Hello, dear students. Today's topic is veins of the head and neck. On the level of head and neck, we have three paired jugular veins. More big of them will be internal jugular vein, next, external jugular vein, and anterior jugular vein. By help of this vein, the oxygenated blood from head and neck goes to heart. Internal jugular vein begins on external surface of base of skull and continues vertically downward in lateral side of neck. On the level of sternoclavicular joint, internal jugular vein joins with subclavian vein and make brachiocephalic vein. Sigmoid sinus, this is one of vein of sinus, continues to jugular notch or foramen jugulare. There we can see jugular notch on base of skull. From external surface of jugular notch begins internal jugular vein. Jugular vein continues with subclavian vein and make brachiocephalic vein. This place where joins two main veins have named venous angle. More anteriorly and medially is larynx, which continues in trachea and thyroid gland. Posteriorly, deep muscle of neck and muscle of back. More laterally, sternocleidomastoid muscle. At the beginning, internal jugular vein lies posteriorly than internal carotid artery. After that, continues more laterally and inferiorly than upper border of thyroid cartilage. Internal jugular vein lies together with common carotid artery and vagus nerve. Right brachiocephalic vein is more short but more wide than left. Both brachiocephalic veins join together and make superior vena cava. As you know, superior vena cava opens in right atrium of the heart. Through this vein to heart goes the oxygenated blood from head, neck, upper limb, and chest. Tributaries of internal jugular vein, we can divide it into groups: intracranial tributaries and extracranial tributaries. Through intracranial tributaries goes venous blood from brain, membranes of brain, bones of neurocranium, and eyes. Through extracranial tributaries goes venous blood from external part of head, viscerocranium, and all structure of neck. First of all, we talk about intracranial tributaries. This is venous sinus. One of them, and more long, will be superior sagittal sinus. Superior sagittal sinus lie in the same name group and finished on the level of internal occipital protuberance, where we have confluence of sinuses. Next, inferior sagittal sinus. This sinus lie in lower border of Falx cerebri. Superior sagittal sinus in upper border of Falx cerebri. Inferior sagittal sinus in lower border, both will be in sagittal plane. Posterior ends of inferior and superior sagittal sinus joined by help of straight sinus or rectus sinus. Straight sinus opens also in confluence of sinuses. In horizontal plane, we can see paired sphenoparietal sinus, which continues in cavernosal sinus Cavernosal sinus will be on both sides from hypophysis. Between these two cavernosal sinus, we have anterior intercavernosal sinus and posterior intercavernosal sinus. After that, deoxygenated blood continues in superior petrosal sinus. Superior petrosal sinus lie in the same name groove, which located on upper border of petrosal part of temporal bone. Superior petrosal sinus opens in transversal sinus. Transversal sinus, this is paired venous sinus, which continues downward in sigmoid sinus. Confluence of sinuses continues in transverse sinus, after that sigmoid sinus, and on the level of jugular notch continues in internal jugular vein. In upper portion in internal jugular vein, we have superior bulb. Next, intracranial tributaries, emissaria vein. Emissaria vein goes through foramen in bones of skull. Action will be joint superficial vein of head with space of venous sinus. On this picture, we see parietal emissaria vein. Next, diploic veins. Diploic veins lie in bone of narrow cranium, have deoxygenated blood from this bone. Diploid veins in parietal bone that we can see, and parietal emissaria vein. Diploic vein, we have frontal diploic vein, anterior temporal vein, posterior temporal diploic vein, and occipital diploic vein. There we have frontal section of head where we can see superior sagittal sinus and inferior sagittal sinus in lower border of halves of brain. Next, intracranial tributaries, this is superficial and deep vein of encephalon, trunk of brain, and cerebellum. There we can see superficial vein of encephalon. Right and left basilar vein, this is deep vein of encephalon, joined together and make vena cerebri magna. This vein have from 1 to 1.5 centimeters long and continuous in straight sinus. Straight sinus opens in confluence of sinuses. Extracranial tributaries. Most of them have the same name and the same topography as artery which begins from external carotid artery. For example, facial vein, superior thyroid vein, posterior auricular vein, occipital vein, partially superficial temporal vein. Now we will talk about superficial temporal vein. This vein have two main tributaries, frontal tributaries and parietal, which join together and make superficial temporal vein. This vein continues downward, anteriorly than ear, and change name on retromandibular vein. Retromandibular vein continues downward, have some tributaries. Zygomatico orbital vein, transversal facial vein, two or three maxillary vein, and after that divided in morbid anterior branch and posterior branch. Posterior branch of retromandibular vein joins with posterior auricular vein and make external jugular vein. anterior branch goes downward and joins with facial vein and sometimes with lingual vein. After that, we'll make common trunk. Common trunk opens in internal jugular vein. Facial vein begins in middle angle of the eyes. There we have supraorbital and supratrochlear tributaries. On the level of root of nose, angular vein continues on face to lower border of mandible. There is superior labial vein, inferior labial vein, submental vein, and after that joins with anterior branch of retromandibular vein and make common trunk. Facial vein have deoxygenated blood from viscerocranium. Occipital vein begins in occipital region, continues downward, and more often opens in external jugular vein or in vertebral vein. In infratemporal fossa, we have pterygoid venous plexus. This plexus makes where joins a lot of more small veins. For example, we have veins from buccal muscle, medial and lateral pterygoid muscle, masseter muscle, from temporal muscle, and also from nasal cavity, sphenopalatine vein, from oral cavity, greater and lesser palatinal vein. After that, pterygoid plexus continues in two or three maxillary veins. These veins continues to retromandibular vein. Inferior alveolar vein more often opens in maxillary vein, sometimes in pterygoid venous plexus, and also deoxygenated blood go in retromandibular vein. From thyroid gland, we have three thyroid veins: superior thyroid vein, middle thyroid vein, and inferior thyroid vein. Superior thyroid vein have also superior laryngeal vein and infrahyoid vein. Together, they make superior thyroid vein, which opens an internal jugular vein. Middle thyroid vein also opened in internal jugular vein. Inferior thyroid vein more often opens in brachiocephalic vein. There we can see pterygoid venous plexus, which lies in infratemporal fossa. In posterior and lateral wall of pharynx, we have venous plexus. From this plexus begins a few pharyngeal veins, which will be extracranial tributaries for internal jugular vein. Posterior branch of retromandibular vein joins with posterior auricular vein and make external jugular vein. External jugular vein continues downward and opens in internal jugular vein or in subclavian vein. Gastrofascia in greater supraclavicular fossa and opens in subclavian vein or internal jugular vein. Anterior jugular vein lie in anterior cervical triangle, have suprahyoid tributaries, and infrahyoid tributaries. Continues downward and more often opens in external jugular vein or in subclavian vein. Have deoxygenated blood only from anterior cervical triangle. Sometimes it can be unpaired vein, only one. There is tributaries of external jugular vein. Thank you for your attention.